Good day, gamers. Purple Mentat here, bringing you episode 8 of my Regrowth Let's Play. It is currently just a little after midnight. I just had to turn off rain because the thunderstorm that was going on was ridiculous, so the folks in chat are, you know, very thankful for that. Since last time, as promised, I have created the iron, coal, tin, and copper seeds, and I've begun upgrading them. They're not all the way there yet. I believe these coal seeds are 999. And I did want to show I got the 10-10-10 copper seeds. We're going to take those over and we're going to make a full plot of them. And I have completely run out of my magical fertilizer. So we're going to be improving that situation. I've altered the farm configuration slightly. I've turned this area over here into just a strip of 4. And this is going to be where we're going to be growing a bunch more mandrake. And I did upgrade one mandrake seed all the way to 10-10-10, as you can see. We're going to get that planted there. We're going to bone meal it up. And we're going to let that start spreading so that we can start producing a ton of easy magical fertilizer. I'm kind of worried not having my skeleton seeds planted at the moment. I dug everything up as I'm, you know, changing things, and I'm planning to expand the base sometime real soon now that I'm getting the resources that I need for that. But at the same time, you know what? We have multiple stacks of the essence, and one stack of the essence will turn into a dozen stacks or more of bone meal. I think we'll be good. Now, one of the things that a viewer pointed out in a few comments, because, you know, they needed to warn me every single video, not realizing that I record a little bit in advance, was that any seed will work in the compost bin. So if you have, for example, extra copper seeds or anything like that, you can dump them in here and get rid of them. So anything that is not up to the level that you want it to be, just get rid of it, toss it into the compost bin, let it turn into beautiful enriched soil. The seeds provide the same progress, from what I can see, as any other bit of vegetable, so you can make pretty quick progress just using seeds. Not a problem. Fantastic. And that'll be a way to take care of all of your extra stuff. Extra seeds, that sort of thing. Now, I want to get a lot of iron quickly, because that's key to my next set of plans. I am tired of waiting because it's been, probably 4 to 6 hours worth of gameplay since last episode. I'm tired of waiting on progression. So what we're going to do, we're going to make a lot of magical fertilizer to speed this along. Hang on a second here. You know what? We're going to swap these two. I'm glad that didn't spawn a mandrake. And there's our... This should be a 10-10-10 mandrake seed. Let's double check. Because these are the 1-1-1s that it didn't stack. Yep, there we go. Growth 10, yield 10, or gain 10. I feel like it should be yield, not gain, because the seeds aren't gaining anything, they're yielding. Okay, so how are we going to set this up so that we don't have nearly as much issue with the mandrakes? Well, punji sticks are the answer. I'm going to be creating a little ring of punji sticks for me to stand inside of. I don't want to set them up around the mandrakes, because the mandrakes will just run over it and get out. But I have noticed that whenever you harvest and a mandrake spawns, which, by the way, if you harvest at night, there's a much lower chance of the mandrake monster spawning. But if you do harvest and a mandrake does spawn, they tend to try to crowd around you and be pretty close. So I did some testing, and I found that having a 2x2 area surrounded by punji sticks on three sides will end up killing off the mandrakes that do spawn pretty reliably. Let's check that out now. Prepare for nausea and shrieking. See? Pretty simple. Worked out very nicely. And out of that mess, I came out with, I already had 4, so 10 mandrakes. Now, if they do not spawn a little guy, then you will get the full complement of 4. But if they do, it only spawns the 1. And if you happen to be standing on the wrong spot when you do, you can just move over in between and wait. And there's, as you saw, I only got the 1 mandrake root. You do get extra seeds when you kill them, but they're always going to be the lowest level of seed at 111. So, yeah, those just end up getting tossed in the compost bin, if I'm being honest about it. Alright, so yeah, there's our source of mandrakes. I've spent a little bit of time gathering a few more as time has gone on, and I'm up to 22 mandrake root, which now means that the limiting factor for me is going to be the wood ash, because it takes 4 wood ash per go to make the mutandis, but hopefully it'll end up working out. Let's see, what do I need? Bone meal and cactus green. I need bone meal in general, so... You know what, let's just keep a few stacks of the skeleton essence on hand in my farming supplies bag. And bones. I need bones. Poof. Yeah, 1 stack of the skeleton essence is more than 3 stacks of bones. And each stack of bones is 3 stacks of bone meal. Yeah, you're not running out anytime soon. Even with as little, technically, as we have of the skeleton essence. So there's 1 stack of skeleton access, skeleton essence turned into bone meal. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and almost 10 full stacks of bone meal came out of that. Fantastic. I love everything about it. Now, we did update the server config files as we found out that the 0.6.5 server download did not have all of the configs updated for the 0.6.5 client. So if you set up your own server of this, cough, Eklis hosting, cough, you're going to want to make sure that you use the configs from the client for now. From what I hear, the Phoenix Lodge is fixing this in the 0.7.0 version that he is currently working on, which is going to include a bunch of recipe updates and a bunch of quest updates. And I believe I saw something like 12 new quests for Witchery so far. So I'm really excited about when that comes out. I'll be doing a changelog episode when it does happen, and we'll cover everything that's gone on. So don't worry, I will actually be making sure you're kept up to date on all of the latest happenings for the pack. There we go, 15 more mutandis, and yeah, we're out of wood ash. Now, these 2x2 spruce wood trees are amazing at generating lots of logs for little effort, but I still need to climb all the way up them and chop them all the way down. It's kind of annoying. However, they do produce more saplings than I spend, so it works out pretty good. I think, though, that I'd be better off, you know what, let's just use half of my reserves, doing 1x1 spruce instead, and that life would be a little bit better that way. Unfortunately, there's no good way to automate your tree growth at this stage, but fortunately, we will be able to start mass producing some... we'll be able to get some better tools, is what I'm trying to say. Wow. Brain derp. In the very near future, which is going to speed that whole process along greatly. So let's make more magical fertilizer, and let's get our iron really rolling here. That gave us just about a stack of it. Yeah. 21 mutandis becomes... So, let me see if I can do the math on this. To make a stack of magical fertilizer, you need 21 mutandis, which requires 7 crafts of mutandis, 7 recipes. Each recipe requires 4 wood ash, so that's a total of 28 saplings per stack of magic fertilizer. Yeah, you're gonna go through it. And why did I produce all of this magic fertilizer? Well, because every magic fertilizer or 2 is gonna give me 2 more iron essence. Right now, I want that iron essence as fast as possible, so I'm going to spend probably half of the magic fertilizer I just created speeding up this plant. I've got 16, that'll give me 2. Yeah, I want to get up to 32 iron essence if I can. Which, not too terribly difficult. Bam, bam, bam. 2 more. Just about half, a little bit less, a little bit less than half. Excellent. Fantastic. So now we've got a couple of things that we can do with the essence of... you know what? Before I go any further, before I continue on and completely forget about the quest book and just start progressing on my own path, because I have never been known to do that before, let's make sure that we actually hand in the 6 unclaimed quests. One evening, while I was waiting on plants to grow and everything, I completed the interference quest because an Enderman spawned directly outside my wall and I was able to bum rush him down without dying. So we're going to collect our enderpearl from that, which also gets us extra reputation with the Arcanist and Mechanist factions. And that still leaves what the world came to be at 95%. Interesting, there's another hidden quest in there we haven't found yet. As you've noticed, these factions, as you get closer to these breakpoints, will change what quests are available in the questbook. And getting one more closer to Mechanist means I only need 5 more points there to unlock something new and exciting. All right, what the world is made of. We have completed Ender Seeds, which we're gonna take the weak essence for all of these because the seeds they're going to reward us with are going to be 111 seeds, I'm pretty sure. So they're all going to end up composted. We've completed coal seeds. We've completed copper seeds. We've completed iron seeds. And we've completed tin seeds. Now, as you can see, we don't have any new quests popping up just yet. Even though we're at 27 out of 30 on the Arcanist now, we're going to have to start investigating some other options. And way down here in... Oh no, was that everything? I think, yes, that was everything. So now I have a choice that I need to make. I can push more for Arcanist, or I can start getting into some mechanizing slightly. If I wanted to do more Arcanist work, I would go make the witching hour, build the witch's oven, and start. As you can see, I needed to get the Arcanist up to at least 20 to be eligible for it, and start in on witchery. And that's actually a pretty good idea, considering if I want to make more magic fertilizer, I'm going to want to do that. So we're going to put a pin on that, and we're going to come back to it sometime very soon. What I'm very interested in doing right now, though, is getting into, I believe, what the world enables. Yes, you may scrape together the beginnings of a workshop grounded in science rather than the arcane. And as you can see, we've unlocked quite a few more options here. The one that I'm going to start with is mixing things up. I need vats. Seeing the way water and lava react with each other has led you to try and develop a controlled environment for mixing substances. You think a vat made of copper is exactly what you need. So, not bats, vats. To make a vat, we need, as it said, copper ingots. Huh, I swore I was going to need a bunch of iron. Anyway, let's analyze all of these seeds that we got as rewards just to make sure that they're garbage. Pretty sure they are. Yeah, look at that 111. Those are getting tossed. And then we're probably going to go spend a little bit more of this magic fertilizer getting some copper together. I know that I'm going to need a bunch of iron today. I really hope that I actually know what I'm talking about here, because it's entirely possible that I'm absolutely, terribly, entirely wrong. As you can see, we have a ton of the ender seeds now, so ender pearls are no longer a limiting factor. You know what? I'm just going to start harvesting. No, I'm not. Actually, I'm going to check in here, and I'm going to grab out my 9 essence of copper, which leaves me one short. We're still going to wait. We're going to let that spread. We're going to get more seeds, and then we'll think about it. Ooh, look at that. 10 seeds. Yay. We're getting closer and closer to tin being complete. Unidentified tin. These should be the 999 tins. Yes, they are. I have so much fun just growing my seeds and improving them, and this pack is a ton of entertainment value. It's like the first time I played with bees. I love AgriCraft. Raider, I think his name was. Hang on, where's the... Anyway, he goes by That One Raider on YouTube. He popped into the last video and left some comments about my spread technique with the seeds. There we are. Now we've got another one. By the way, let me show you something else cool that I figured out. Also, I wanted that tin. So if I were to place seeds right here, that'll cover these three. If I were then to go place seeds right here, it'll cover these three, which don't overlap with this one at all. If you do that on the same block all the way around, it only takes 4 seeds to have a grown, mature plant adjacent to every other plant on the plot. that is going to be your most efficient configuration because it's going to give you the maximum number of places that seeds could spread to at any given time. So that's what you're going to want to do for that. Okay, let's get this vat made. Now, the iron and the copper essence, there's only a couple of uses for these. We'll start with the copper. As you can see, you can make 6 ore out of 8 essence. And that's pretty good, but we're going to need 7 ingots. If we want to process that ore, though, we have literally zero options right now. The options available to us in the pack are pretty fun, but we don't have access to any of those yet. So the only thing we can really do with this iron this early on is toss it into... Well, actually, let's make sure that they didn't change the grindstone recipe on me. Yeah, we don't have Sirtis Quartz. We don't have Nether Quartz. To make Nether Seeds, we would need to visit the Nether. To make Sirtis Seeds, yeah, that's not happening right now. Moving on. It's gonna be a bit. So yeah, our only option is to pretty much just cook this into ingots. But that's okay, because we're gonna be building a better option very soon, very quickly. So we know we need 7 ingots. Let's just cook those up right now so that we can get our vat created. And the vat is going to allow for a lot of cool options that some of which are going to be on progression and some of which are going to be a little sequence breaky, which, you know, that's the best kind. Those are the most fun. I'm going to need 4 mandrake. We're going to just, while that processes, I'm going to make a little bit more magical fertilizer and I'll be right back, folks. All right, made some more magical fertilizer, cooked things up, and we're making 32 iron ore now. We're going to get that cooking because I want a proper bucket. I really do. And actually, yeah, you know what? We're just going to go 8 more. We're going to go ahead and spend 16 of our iron ore in the furnace. I want a proper bucket. This clay bucket, I mean, yeah, that's good and all, but it's not going to hold up to transporting lava. And that's one of the very next things I want to do. So here's our vat from Mariculture. And you know what? We're just going to toss it down in the world briefly. Don't worry, now that I actually have proper materials, we're going to be doing some serious cosmetic expansion of the base sometime in the near future. But first things first, we need to be able to at least get slightly better than 1 ingot per craft, or 1 ingot per ore out of our essence, you know? Because that's just not going to cut. Ooh, iron seeds. Yay! Very happy about this. So these will be the 9 iron seeds for when you're chipping out of the rough or something. I don't know. There's a golf joke in there. I don't know anything about golf. So why did I want a real bucket? Because if I use lava on this fired clay bucket, it's going to disappear. In fact, I'm going to demonstrate that right now. I built a tiny little cobblestone gen down here because I thought that that might be a better way of getting cobblestone than diving into the earth and destroying smooth stone. And I forgot that cobblestone actually goes slower than smooth stone. So yeah, with this flint tool and one spot for cobblestone, don't do this. This is a terrible idea. It takes forever and you get nothing out of it. You will be so bored. Also, don't accidentally turn all of the lava that you wanted to use into obsidian the way I did. Don't be like me. That's what I'm saying right here. Don't be me. Okay, so if we put a bucket of lava, which consumes our clay bucket, and a bucket of water into this vat at the same time, you can see something begins to happen. Wow, that's actually going to take a moment. All that processes. We get 4 burnt bricks and 4 clay buckets full of lava out of this quest. That's kind of funny, actually. Unfortunately, that's also going to destroy the amount of space that I have available to me. That won't do at all. I don't have that kind of inventory space at the moment. We shall fix this, though. This is a solvable issue. Because I have all of this extra junk that I don't need to have in my inventory right now. And bump, bump, there. Hey, look at that. Organization. Who would have thought it out of me? Like, everything has a place. And there we go. As you can see, it turns into obsidian, which you can grab out of the vat. We're going to be using this obsidian very, very soon. And in fact, I wonder if that unlocked a quest in What the World is Made Of. No, it did not. That's a shame. That's okay. So back to what the world enables. We have finished mixing things up. We get our 4 burnt brick and our 4 lava clay buckets. Now this is awesome because burnt brick is actually relatively annoying to get your hands on early on in mariculture. We need to literally put bricks, nether bricks or regular bricks, into a vat of lava, and it's going to use half a bucket of lava per brick or quarter bucket of lava per nether brick and 16 seconds per burnt brick that it creates. So yeah, with no good way to automate things and a limited ability to transport lava right now, getting extra burnt brick is good because we're going to be needing a lot of it very, very soon. So let's see. What are our options? Okay, good. Crucible of Fire. You've started producing some metals, but directly smelting them in a simple stone oven is incredibly inefficient. Let's see if we can do better. I was hoping it would get me straight to this. Lava-tempered brick should allow you to create a crucible furnace. That's the plan. Capable of withstanding the higher temperatures necessary to melt your metals in a molten state, extracting more metal from each ore. So we need 2 crucible furnaces. Let's check out the recipe for that. It does use 2 burnt brick each, and a bucket of lava. Hey, convenient, huh? It's going to need some brick construction blocks. Rah. Which use iron bars and more burnt bricks. So unfortunately, it's up to 6 burnt bricks each. It's going to use some fluid tanks, which those are pretty simple. Glass, wood, and copper. And it's going to use some heating elements. These are the annoying bit. We need to make silicon carbide. To make silicon carbide, we need to combine sand, clay, and coal. Very specifically, coal. And this is why we have been spending our time improving our coal essence. And in fact, I should have a pile of it waiting in this chest. Not a ton of it yet. In fact, I am going to spend a little bit more magic fertilizer speeding this along. There we go. I want to get up to 16. And because these are 999 coal seeds, they are providing 3 essence per gather. So if I combine these in the traditional way, each craft gets me 12 coal. Fantastic. No more burning trees for charcoal to fuel my furnace. Happy about that. All right. So as you saw, I need to create a bunch of bricks, which is going to come out of clay, which unfortunately we're low on clay. So I'm going to spend some time generating clay, cooking bricks in my furnace out of clay, like so. Clay will be generated at the Clayconia, as usual. Get one more in there so it's efficient. And then I'm going to be taking those bricks, dumping them into the lava-filled vat so that I can produce burnt bricks like so. It's going to be a bit of a grindy process, but once I have myself a handful of burnt bricks, we will be able to progress. So I'll be back when we're ready to build the crucible furnace. See you then. All right, folks. So to get the... Wow. Mouse, go wild. To get the burnt bricks made, we're going to need quite a bit more lava than I have really easy access to. Digging around under my base to get it a bucket at a time, that's not going to fly. So instead, we're going to make the fluid tanks, because I believe that I can place these in the world, put some fluid in them, and then pick them back up and they'll retain their fluid inventory. We're going to double check that right now, though. Yes, it still contains 1,000 millibucket of water. Put it back down, the water's still there. Fantastic. And we're not even going to bother with the lava directly under the base. We're going to go all the way down. Because way down here in this little underground ravine... Hope you're not afraid of heights, as I tend to do a lot of falling from ladders. It's just the way I get around. You can see that there is plenty of lava waiting here for us. And we're gonna cut a little staircase down to it. Fantastic. Let's see. We can put you there, and that will block the water flow. Yay! And we're going to just start gathering up a bunch of lava for a couple of reasons. One, it's going to help a lot with the burnt brick. Two, getting a nether portal built in the very near future is definitely an option, and there is a quest to go there. And that would make gathering even more lava well, I wouldn't exactly say easy because it's the Nether with Natura and biomes aplenty, so, you know, there's that. I need you. There we go. Trying to scoop off the top layer because all of these flowing fluid block updates end up being a little difficult on the server and really difficult on people's graphics. I don't think there's ever going to be anyone within render distance of me, or at least not anytime soon, that's for certain. So that's not as much of a worry, but I definitely don't want to leave it with any sort of ticking block, and I believe that the flowing fluid will cause updates as it attempts to recalculate where should it be flowing to. So do your server a favor and scoop off an entire layer of lava at a time. The admins will thank you. There we are. And you know what? That's 21 buckets of lava. That'll do for right now. We're going to take those back upstairs with us and go get some work done. I'll see you at the top. All right, we're back up top. I'm going to save these clay buckets of lava for the actual crafting. I've got 32 bricks in my vat, and I'm going to start filling in some lava. We're going to do it from the less empty tank first. Oh, there we go. It's full. Can only hold 12 bricks worth at a time. But yeah, there we go. And I found a cool surprise when I came back up. My coal and, ooh, my belladonna and my iron seeds had all spread. So let's see. People are complaining about the titanium that's going to be necessary in the pack, and I'm just all, I got plans, yo. All right, so we got iron at 10, 10, 10. We're going to make an iron field. My copper field is mostly there already. And we're going to get that iron down right here to start. Those are the 10, 10, 10, right? Yep, good. And we can fertilize that, get it grown. Once you have a full field of metal, you're pretty much set. Because being able to come back to an entire stack of it waiting for you to pick up, which you can then turn into... 64 essence will turn into 48 of the ore. Yeah, you're in good shape whether you are doubling your ores or not at that point. It almost doesn't matter. Really, the reason I'm building ore multiplication devices this early is because I'm going to want them when I start doing things that take a lot longer to grow. Things such as gold or other high and late game metals. All right, let's get that belladonna planted back down. Yes, I'm sure the comments are already rolling in about more inventory management with Purple Mentat. Guess what? Inventory management's a part of the game. You don't like it? Go find someone that doesn't ever show any inventory management on his videos. I dare you. And then, yeah, like, link him to me because that's amazing and I want to see those videos. And get the coal seeds going. And by then, hopefully... we'll be in a good spot as far as my brick is concerned. Let's see if that's... oh, darn it. Good, we're starting to run low on bread finally. You'll notice that I don't have wheat seeds planted. It's because we're going to start using a different, better food sometime very soon. All right, now, if you right-click on these, you will only take out the burnt brick that are done, unless you right-click again, at which point you'll grab out the bricks that are still processing. Okay. Boom, 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 boom. I believe there were 5 buckets in here. I might have had another bucket in the actual bucket. And you know what? We're just going to let it all burn up all of the lava and then we'll worry about it after that. So coal and belladonna we can go get rid of into the composter. And then we can finally start crafting ourselves some of at least the first one of the crucible furnace. The first craft, you know what? It might only need one recipe. I can't remember if I get 2 crucible furnaces out of the recipe anymore. But let's find out. So step one, we need our clay, our sand, and our coal. Looking up the blast furnace because that's what we were talking about. The crucible furnace requires heating components made from silicon carbides, and we're going to need 6 of them so that we can make 2 of the heating components. Oops, sorry about that. Very unprofessional there. Left my phone alarm waiting. We need to go grab one of them fluid tanks up. Come here, you. And now we can... Oh yeah, we only get one out of this. Okay. The brick construction blocks are going to require some iron bars, but it doesn't require a ton of iron bars, so, you know, don't use them all up. We're going to be using a ton of these brick construction blocks over time, but for right now, just make the two because you need to save your burnt brick to make the actual furnace itself, which you cannot shift-click because reasons. Okay, here, here, there. Helps if you actually put things in the right spaces. One crucible furnace. Now we just need the other one. So, I'm just going to let the materials that I need finish processing. Because, actually, I need more coal to be able to do it. That's the main thing that I'm lacking. Let's speed up our coal production some then by just grabbing up some of the essence. Boom, boom. There we are. I had 19, oh, 3 in there, but that's not enough to actually make any coal with. Here we go. That's 24 coal, and I'm going to need more clay, but I've got a ton of that lying around now thanks to the Clayconia production. I am a liar. All right, anyway, I'll be right back. I'm going to get that other crucible furnace crafted. See you in a bit. All right, we're going to run just a little bit over time today because I want to get this crucible furnace up and running. First thing we're going to need to do is get one more set of fluid tanks, crafted. There's our second crucible furnace. And now we can hand in that quest, I bet. Check that out. Ooh, no, castaway. It does want me to make the ladle, ingot caster, and block caster. That's okay. I was prepared for this. We have 14 burnt brick on hand. Make the ingot caster as a simple setup like that. Or the block caster, on the other hand, you're going to need 8 of them. So be ready for that. And the ladle is a device that I hope to spend 0 time with. It uses up 3 iron ingots. It can hold 1 ingot's worth of metal at, or whatever material you're putting in there, at a time. Now, this is going to get us 8 burnt brick and 4 lava clay buckets again, which is fantastic because it's going to help a lot with continued production. Oh, by the way, the castaway. Once you've melted down your metals, you need to cool them back into a more usable state. A mold for ingots and a mold for blocks should suffice. To move the molten metal from the crucible furnace to the mold, you'll want a ladle which will hold an ingot's worth of liquid at once. Don't listen to that quest. It is lying to you and wants you to suffer. We are going to put this fluid tank down right here, and we're going to put our 2 crucible furnaces on top of it, forming the multi-block crucible tank, crucible furnace structure, which is going to be powered by the lava inside of that tank. Now, I believe you can configure it to only work when it has a redstone signal. So then we can come over here and we can grab a stick and a bit of cobblestone, and we can produce for ourselves a lever. Stuff that on the side of this guy, and now he's only going to work when available. You can also configure this guy to auto-eject fluids and then stuff your ingot caster, which for some reason is unnamed right there. That's strange. Right next to the crucible furnace. And be careful jumping around on this vat. No, it doesn't look like I can actually fall in. Anyway, we're going to put... This is all very temporary. Don't worry, I'm going to be building some better setups soon, but I want iron to build with. And now that we have our iron seeds spreading, by the way, we also finished tin. Speaking of spreading, we have some growth. Good. Come here, you. And we're going to go plant you over here where you can be more efficiently filling this area. As you can see, we've already... Ooh, good. There we go. That's the last bit of the coal that I need. Sorry, sidetracked. This is going to happen frequently because I love the farming in this pack. There we go. That is slightly off. That's okay. I missed the pattern. I can fix this. I can fix this. There. Now the pattern is fulfilled. Yay. I feel better now. Yeah, you start from these 4 blocks and you cover every single block in the plot. We covered that earlier this episode. I don't know why I'm telling you again. Probably because I got distracted. So, let's see what this crucible furnace can do for us. Now, it needs to get up to temperature to be able to melt anything. If I put my... Ooh. Should have seen that crash coming. The frames per second was getting a little low and things were showing up unnamed. I imagine a strange NEI bug there. Anyway, you're going to need to get these guys up to temperature, 1538 Celsius for the iron, but once it is there, and it'll happily consume the lava a little bit at a time to get there, just 10 millibuckets of lava will last quite a while in the crucible furnace. Once it gets there, it'll melt relatively quickly. You just need to get it up there, and it takes a little bit. There are upgrades that can speed this along. For example, the heating upgrade. That's the debug version. How about we try the basic heating upgrade? As you can see, it just takes a couple heating components and an iron ingot. And then you can upgrade your upgrades into better and better once you start crafting some of the more exotic metals like aluminium. Or, from there, actually it's just another pile of iron and aluminium. So you can get to the advanced heating upgrades as soon as you have your aluminium. Alright, so we're going to leave that, let that heat up a bit. The great thing about this whole setup right now, the upgrades go right in these slots, by the way, is it's going to take a little while to get to temperature, but once it's there, this will process fairly quickly. And then 4 ingots at a time is going to go into the ingot caster. As you can see, 0 out of 576 millibuckets is what it takes. It's 576 millibuckets to 4 ingots is what I'm trying to say. You divide that by 4, you end up with 144 millibuckets per ingot. If I take a look at this, these are going to melt into 216 millibuckets. That's 72 millibuckets, or half of an ingot more than we would have gotten by smelting it in the furnace. So we have gotten ourselves to 1.5 times ore processing, and it took, for the most part, relatively little effort. And if we want to fuel it, well, I mean, that lava tank is actually really cheap to fuel. It doesn't cost an awful lot. We're already at 145 degrees, and once we have a bunch of heating elements in there made from all of that iron that we're going to be producing, we'll be able to make that go even faster. Honestly, our sticking point at the moment is lava, but having the ability to go down and collect another 16 buckets, well, 17 buckets if I fill this thing, at a time in this fluid tank is going to speed that up immensely. So it's not that big of a worry as far as these things go. Hang on. Must manage crops. I swear I could spend all day just managing crops in AgriCraft. I love it. It's fun. And there might be something wrong with me. I'm not certain. What do you guys think? Is this a, bug or a feature? Is this intended levels of fun or a disease? You tell me. 3, 1, 2, 3. There we go. Yeah, that's right. Now we've actually got the proper pattern going. And as you can see, the coal is spreading. The tin is improving. We're getting places. Things are good. Right here. Yeah, there we go. Yes, I like it. I like everything about it. Okay, folks. So I believe that's going to be all of the time that we have for today between episodes. Actually, you know what? I'm going to do one last cut back in once this thing's full just to show you how easily it gets into fluid form and becomes ingots in the ingot caster stuck right next to it. See you in a moment. All right, as you can see, we're about halfway to getting our iron. Well, actually, about two-thirds of the way. But while you're in the crucible furnace, you can see the melting point of other things, and there are some, for example, tin, that have a very low melting point. As you can see, once you've reached the melting point, it begins processing at, I think, around the speed of a furnace, maybe slightly slower. But once again, that is something that can be upgraded with the... I think it can be upgraded. You know what? It might just be the heating upgrade makes it process faster as well. As you can see, so this 2 tin ore became 6 ingots worth and outputted into here. We have right now ingots 3 out of roughly 4. There we go. Now it's starting to process. So 2 ore is turning into 3 ingots. As you can see, I have 2 ingots in here. And 4 in here, all you need to do is wait for it to finish cooling, and then you can grab your 4 ingots out. You're going to want to do these 4 at a time, which the easiest way to do that is just put your ore into the crucible furnace in multiples of 4. Tin is done at a melting point of 232, iron at 1538, copper at 1085, and it's relatively efficient on fuel. I did go down into the bowels of the earth and get myself another fluid tank worth while I was waiting for things to melt, but it's really not that bad. Now, the other great thing about the Crucible Furnace, if I remember correctly, it will not produce alloys in its tank. In fact, until I have emptied out all of the molten tin, it will not even melt this copper, despite us being well over the melting point of copper. There we are. Hang on just a moment. Let's get this done. Huh, somehow I miscalculated. But that's an easy fix. If you do find yourself with just a little bit not quite right. Oh, you know what? You don't even need to do that. If you just leave two ingots in there, they will eventually cool into two ingots. That's fantastic. I did not know it did that, and I'm actually very happy that it does. So let's spread our copper. I'm going to get all of my copper, tin, and iron processed between episodes. I'll have a ton of ingots next time. And anytime that I want more, it'll be very easy to come over here and harvest a bunch more essence from my essence farms. Basically, as far as copper, tin, and iron are concerned, I feel like we're pretty much done. Things are set. And also, if I decide that I'm sick of going down and getting lava to fuel the thing, I can easily make myself, hang on, some blocks of coal, like so. And this will be a fairly efficient way to fuel things, because a block of coal has a very long burn time. And I don't know how this mod handles it, but technically, oh, there we go. Mariculture per temp solid, 378 degrees, max temp 2000. So that will add 278 degrees over the course of its burning time and can get it to a max of 2000, because coal is one of the best options. Now, you may notice that it was at 238 for the... Huh. Hang on a second. Let me look that up. That might be a little odd. No, 378. Okay, that's good. So, 9 coal on its own would be 360 degrees, so you get a tiny bonus for using a block instead of just the coal itself. So yeah, there you go. You have some basic ore processing. Next time, we're going to use some of these ingots to progress in Botania so that I can get myself something really nice that's going to allow me to build some very pretty things, and I'm really happy about that. Thank you very much for joining me, folks. I hope you have enjoyed this slightly longer than usual episode. If you have, please leave a thumbs up and let me know what you liked about it so that I keep showing up in your subscriber feed. If you have not, then please leave a thumbs down and tell me what you disliked so that I can improve. And I will see you next time.